Let's do it. This is our UYCAZ. Hey, this is our UYCAZ. Hey, keeping the faith in the kingdom, and the patience will give us those freedoms.
So he wasn't judging you, he was just showing you, okay, well let me, yes sir. So what he was saying was, well let me show you a law that you don't know, you might not know about. That's all he was saying. He wasn't saying, hey brother, such and such, no, he wasn't getting on you. He was just, hey brother, you don't know about this because I can't see it on you. You got your head covered, but I'll praise you, uncovered it because you fear God. That's what he was sharing with you, all right? Listen to this real quick.
This is the book of Sirach, chapter 19, verse 29. A man may be known by his look.
By his what?
By his look.
So when somebody see him, anybody that see that man would say, what? He's a what? He's a what? He's a bum. Because he's known by his what? By his look. You understand what I'm saying? So when we see you, we went off what your attire was. Read.
And one that have understanding by his countenance.
Read.
When thou meetest him.
Read from the top.
Verse 29, a man may be known by his look.
Uh-huh.
And a one that have understanding by his countenance when thou meetest him.
Read.
A man's attire and excessive laughter and gait show what he is.
So the way a man walk, talk, and dress will show what he is. So that's what the brother was sharing with you, all right? All right? Hey, Steve. Steve, come over here real quick. It's Steve, right? Steve from the tribe of Ephraim. Y'all brothers, like y'all get down together, you your partner? Yeah. So you said that you had watched this before, correct? What stopped you from watching?
Nothing, actually. Well, actually, I forgot I had no computer.
Right, right. What about, you got a phone? Okay. Library? All right, so check this out.
I do got my fringes on.
No. Because it's supposed to go all the way around, according to the scriptures. All right, so the thing that I call you over for is because if you followed us and you know what the Israelites are about, what did Ephraim do that make them fall away from God? Okay, and you're from the tribe of Ephraim, correct? They started worshiping images.
What?
Idols.
So what you got in your neck? What is that? Images. They are images that you're not supposed to have according to the Bibles. This is one of the ways we fell away from God. Give me Leviticus 26 and 1. All right, this is one of the things, and then you're going to keep it. Those are your possessions. That's what happened to our people, man. They held on to things. Matter of fact, give me Ezekiel 30 and 33. 33 and 30, I believe it is. 33 and 30. Ezekiel, is that what I want? What it say?
This is the book of Ezekiel, chapter 33 and verse 30. Also, thou son of man, the children of thy people still are talking against thee by the walls and in the doors of the houses, and speak one to another, everyone to his brother, saying, come, I pray you, and hear what is the word that cometh forth from the Lord.
So they come and hear the word from the Lord. That's what our people was doing. All of those tribes, they was coming to hear the word. Read.
Verse 31. And they come unto thee as a people cometh, and they sit before thee as my people.
So we sit before the Most High when we hear his word as his people, right? Because we are his people, right? The so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. We are the people, the children of God. Read.
And they hear thy words.
They do what?
And they hear thy words.
Do y'all hear the words coming out of the Bible? Read.
But they will not do them.
We will not do what the Bible says. The Bible says, now give me that. Give me that one. Leviticus 26 and 1. All right, so he said, they hear my words, but they will not do them. We were not supposed to ever, 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 ever have any images. Read.
This is the book of Leviticus, chapter 26, verse 1. Ye shall make no idols, nor graven image.
So you shouldn't hold on to it, Steve. Because that's something that we were not supposed to do, ever. Read it from the top.
Ye shall make no idols, nor graven image. Neither will you up a standing image. Neither shall you set up any image of stone in your land to bow down unto it, for I am the Lord your God.
Who is the Lord our God? The God of this Bible. The God of Isaac, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Give me Isaiah 30 and 22. Isaiah 30 and 22. Let me show you what the Bible says, what you're supposed to do with those images. Watch this. Because it's in the Bible. And the reason why I said that, because the Most High knew he was going to transgress it. And when we transgressed it, he gave us a way of getting rid of it. Watch this.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 30, verse 22.
Bring it out.
You shall defile all the coverings of thy graven images of silver, and the ornament of thy molten images of gold.
That's what those things are made out of, silver, gold, wood, whatever. They man-made, read.
Thou shalt cast them away.
You shall do what?
Thou shalt cast them away.
What cast them away mean? Read.
As a mistress cloth.
What's a mistress cloth? What's a mistress cloth, brother? A mistress cloth. What about a woman? You understand? So what do they do with that? Do they keep it, hold on to it for a day or so? Read it from the top.
Thee shall defile also the covering of thy graven images of silver, and the ornaments of thy molten images of gold. Thou shalt cast them away as a mistress cloth.
That's why when I seen it on you, I'm like, you know you're an Israelite. You're not supposed to be doing that. We're not getting on you, brother. We're just trying to show you.
Yeah, because I'm still learning.
Right. That's right.
I got in them suit in 2013.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know that the Bible.
Right.
Brother called me out.
Right. All right. All right. All praise. So that's why we're glad that you, brother, stopped by. So we know that you might be fellowshipping other places, but take that flyer. Go on the website. Learn. We got videos to tell you about images. We got videos to show you about your heritage. We have videos to show you about baptism, being born again, how to keep his commandments. All of these things we have videos on to show you, to help you walk better. All right.
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.